What's up, Internet? So, natapos mo na yung Bibili Ka series and you're ready to buy a computer. Congrats! Pero anong dapat bilhin mo? What you buy depends on what you need the PC for. Pang office ba? Pang gaming? Pang editing? Pang kalokohan? Para hindi masayang pera mo, here are our builds for budgets 10K to 30K. Office PC, light gaming PC, light editing PC. Sa mga budgets na to, kada piso mahalaga.
Ang video na to ay handog ni cdkoffers.com. Marami kang mahahanap na iba't ibang uri ng software dito. May games, apps, activation codes for Windows 10. Check out our video on CDK Offers in the video description. Mabilis, mura, and syempre legit dito. Madali lang mag-order, search for the software you need, add to cart, check out, daan ka sa payment options nila, wala pa isang minuto, finished. May legit working CDK ka na sa software na pinili mo. Gamitin ang aming promo code para makakuha pa ng extra 20% discount sa purchase mo. Kung naghahanap ka ng mura, legit, and original software, check out cdkoffers.com.
Hindi naman tayo lahat swerte na yung office natin yung magbabayad, tapos yung mga boss natin hindi masyadong techy, hindi alam kung magkano ba talaga dapat yung budget para sa isang laptop or sa isang desktop. First up, 10,000 peso build for the office for word processing, Excel files, and surfing the internet. Like our other Bibili Ka series, we'll go through it part by part. Simula tayo sa CPU. For this price range, actually, I'd recommend Intel. They have a lot of cheap CPUs which are readily available, specifically the G series under their Pentium line. So that's like the Pentium G4620 or the Pentium G4600. You can get those for around 3,000 pesos. And that's really all you need for an office computer. AMD has nothing comparable in this price range. For GPU, don't get a GPU. Make sure that the CPU you get already has integrated graphics para hindi ka gagastos para sa GPU. And again, a lot of the Intel CPUs at this price range may integrated graphics na siya. Para sa motherboard, marami namang options available. Tapos yung maganda pa choosing an Intel Pentium G series is that it's socket 1151 and there are a lot of cheap socket 1151 motherboards. Usually get an M80X motherboard. They're usually cheaper than a full-sized ATX board. The Pentium G series is actually covered under Intel 7th Gen Kaby Lake. So this has been around since 2017. It is recognized technology and it's very easy to find compatible parts. For RAM, get 2x4. So that's two sticks of 4GB for a total of 8GB. Don't get RGB RAM. Mas mura yung non-RGB kasi bilis lang yung speed ng non-RGB tsaka RGB RAM. For storage, get a 250GB SATA SSD. Yes, even for office PCs, we recommend getting an SSD. Sobrang laki ng quality of life improvement mo with an SSD. Kahit anong build mo, get yourself an SSD. You can get a 240GB SSD from us for 1,700 pesos. For the PSU and case, usually at this price point, you can get generic options which come bundled together, saving you more money. Usually, we don't recommend generic PSUs. The old joke is na parang the bomb has been planted yan sa CS. Hinihintay mo na lang na sasabog yan or it will fail. Pero to be honest, kung office computer lang, hindi naman siya ganun ka-demanding. And a generic PSU will probably be fine for years. We've had office computers last 6, 10 years, generic PSU. Kasi yun nga, hindi naman grabe yung demands ng office computer. And a generic PSU usually is fine. And it saves you a ton of money. For cooling, again, no need to get additional cooling for the CPU or for the case. Office computers and these specs won't run hot. The stock fan of the CPU, the stock fans of the case, if it comes with any, it will be completely okay. If you really want a recommendation for a generic brand of case and PSU, then we've tried Fortress in the past and they seem to be reliable. But there are so many different cases and PSUs at this price point on the market. Usually, just pick whatever your PC shop has and hope for the best. 15K faster office computer. Henyo pala yung empleyado mo at kailangan niya ng mas mabilis na computer. Dami niyang tabs na nakabukas. No problem. You just need to upgrade two things. One, get a faster CPU. You can get an i3 7th gen or even an 8th gen depending on your budget. Yun yung maganda sa 1151 socket, ang daming available na compatible. Number 2, increase the RAM to 16GB. So 2x8, total of 16GB. Those two differences, getting a faster CPU and more RAM, will make the office PC much faster. 25K basic gaming rig / light editing rig. After you've written your words, computed your excels, and closed your tabs, you want to use the PC for what it was invented for, gaming. Real talk, 25K isn't a lot for a gaming PC. It will play most games at lower settings. It can definitely play this game, no problem. You just need to set your expectations. Kung may nagsabi sa'yo na high-end gaming rig, 25K, 35K, medyo magduda ka na sa kanya. First, the CPU. Here, I recommend AMD. Their 3200G or 3400G Ryzen CPUs are excellent value for their money. These are still APUs or CPUs with integrated graphics, so hindi mo kailangan bumili ng graphics card, and that saves you a lot of money. For a motherboard, you can get an A320 or B450 board. Again, MATX boards are usually cheaper. For RAM, definitely get 2x8 or 16GB total of RAM. Non-RGB pa rin para mas mura. Storage, 250GB. SATA SSD for sure, but add at least 1TB hard drive. Mapupuno ka agad yung SSD with the OS, not to mention the files that you usually have such as photos and videos. So for this build, it definitely needs more storage. Sa PSU naman, wag na tayo, the bomb has been planted. Let's get a branded PSU. At least one na 80 plus bronze rated. And there are actually a lot of affordable PSUs in this price range. 550W from EVGA, Cooler Master, or Corsair. And we're spending a bit more for the PSU para maasahan natin siya. We're going to use this rig for gaming at magandang upgrade platform din to. At least safety tayo na bumili ng mas mahal na components later on kasi maasahan natin yung PSU. For casing, there are a lot of options here in this price range. People usually buy Rack or Techware or Dark Flash. Deepcool also has some good cases in this price range. And as for cooling, no need to get a third-party CPU cooler. The stock cooler of AMD is already pretty good for what you need. And some of the cases already have RGB fans with their own controller included. Later on down the line, this is actually a good upgrade platform as well. Just add one more component. Just get a GPU, say like a 1650 or a 1660, and that will greatly expand the lifespan of this rig. Last tip at the 25K range, if you're thinking of using it for light editing, be sure to get 32GB of RAM. More RAM, less hassle pagdating sa editing. And thank you to our top fans! Na-afford na namin itong upuan na to! Hindi, joke lang. Thank you to Leah Magnaye, Ian Meru, Richard Onkinko, ITX Addict, John Ruben Ocha, Christian Espinosa, and Rafael James. Thank you for supporting the channel.